under bryophytes as well as pteridophytes, and examples, classifications of bryophytes and pteridophytes. Let's begin with the first one, that is bryophytes. Bryophytes are the simplest and primitive land plants. They are the old ones. Next is, they are the first amongst land plants which occur in damp and shady habitats. Bryophytes includes liverworts and mosses. You know, students, bryophytes are also known as amphibians of the plant kingdom. Why is it so? Because bryophytes live in soil, but they have to depend on water for their sexual reproduction. Next is, rhizoids are organs of absorption and fixation. So, rhizoids are present in bryophytes, which are the organs of absorption and fixation. Next one, six organs under bryophytes are multicellular. It means two sex organs are present. One is the male and one is the female. So which one is the male? Antheridium. And which one is the female? Archegonium. This is the first time under this classification in plant kingdom two sex organs are appearing. Next is, the life cycle of bryophytes is divided into two distinct phases. One is the gametophytic phase and other one is the saprophytic phase. Now, moving on to the classification under bryophytes. Bryophytes is divided into three. It's classified into hepaticopsida, anthoceropsida and bryopsida. Let's take some characteristics under hepatocopsida. Hepatocopsida are the liverworts. These plants are having thyroid and gamete are present. Gamete are the organs that are responsible for asexual reproduction. It's asexual reproduction. Next is, ileters are present in case of hepaticopsida. Examples under hepaticopsida are Ricea, Palea and Merchantia. Next is Anthoceropsida. What is this? These are the horn gods. And the sex organs under Anthoceropsida are present on the dorsal surface of thallus. The sex organs are present on the dorsal surface of thallus. Examples are Anthoceros, Megaceros and Dendroceros. Moving on to Bryophytes. Bryophytes are the mosses. They bear observed that these are the most primitive and oldest known land inhabiting plants. So if any question comes in the exam like which is the most primitive and oldest known plant category, then it is Phylloxera. These are rootless, they don't have roots, they are also known as whisk ferns. The examples under Phylloxera is Xyloderm. It's easy to learn the example. I already told you in previous lectures how to learn the examples. It's very easy. Next is Lycopsida. Lycopsida are also known as club moss or ground pine. They show variation in morphology. There is no one particular morphological category under Lycopsida. They show variations. Next is example Selaginella and Lycopodia. Spinopsida. Spinopsida are also known as horse tails. Under Spinopsida, Equisetum is the only living genus. This is very important point. Equisetum is the only living genus under Spinopsida. Comes Pteridophytes. Under Pteridophytes, ferns are there. Next is plants are perennials. Under Pteridophytes, the plants are perennials. Adiantum is an example under Pteridophytes. This is an example under Pteridophytes, which is also known as maiden hair fern or walking fern. So we have discussed Pteridophytes and the classification under Pteridophytes. Go through your books and learn more about both these classifications. In our next lecture, we will take angiosperms and gymnosperms.